welcome. I'm Brian Musburger. Again, I'll be working alongside Billy Packer, and one of the big matchups we'll be seeing here tonight, the battle for the middle. Dwayne Schintzius of Florida is 7-2. He says he will try to get Rony Seikaly into early foul trouble.
I'll go with him, and I'm sure he's going to be coming at me. I'll give him a few head fakes, and yes, I'll try to get him in foul trouble, because with him sitting on the bench, I think the inside game will be opened up just a little more.
But Rony Seikaly has been in the pit against the likes of Patrick Ewing, and he says getting him in foul trouble will not be easy.
I don't think he's too much of a power player. He's more of a finesse player that's going to stand on the high post, try to pass it off, and if he does get it inside, maybe give you a turnaround jump shot or hook shot. He's not the power player that might get you in foul trouble, but we never know, though.
That's the battle in the middle, Billy, but in that backcourt, we have Vernon Maxwell of Florida, Sherman Douglas of Syracuse, another key duel.
It really is, and Brent, we may be looking at next year's first-team All-American guards, because they're both underrated, in my opinion. In regard to Maxwell, we're talking about an athlete that the Florida football coaches say may be the best football player they have on campus. He has big numbers offensively, but what I'm looking forward to tonight is if Sherman Douglas gets off to a big start and Norm Sloan has to move Maxwell over on him, how good an athlete are we talking about? This young man right here, Sherman Douglas, has done it against everybody. And the performance he put on against Georgetown showed me he likes the big game.
All right, so coming up, it is Florida against Syracuse. Back with the starting lineups in a moment. In the Brendan Byrne Arena, the New Jersey Meadowlands, we will have the East Region Semifinal between the Gators of Florida and the Orangemen of Syracuse. Now, the road here, Florida got here by beating North Carolina State and then Purdue, a couple of upsets, if you will. As for Syracuse, they were favored. They were home in the Carrier Dome. They beat back Georgia Southern and Western Kentucky to get into this semifinal matchup. Now, we're going to meet the starting lineups for these two teams. Let's go to Dom Elagio, the PA announcer.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Meadowlands Arena for this evening's East Regional semifinal game between the University of Florida Gators and the Orangemen of Syracuse University. Now let's meet the starting lineups. For Florida, at forward, a 6'6 senior from Crestview, Florida, number 4, Joe Lawrence. For Syracuse, at forward, a 6'9 freshman from Detroit, Michigan, number 44, Derrick Coleman. For Florida, at forward, a 6'5 senior from Pahokee, Florida, number 34, Melvin Jones. At forward, a 6'5 senior from Syracuse, New York, number 25, Howard Trish. For Florida, at center, a 7'2 freshman from Brandon, Florida, number 33, Dwayne Schintzius. For Syracuse, at center, a 6'10 junior from Athens, Greece, number 4, Rony Seikaly. For Florida, guard, a 6-foot senior from Quincy, Florida, number 5, Andrew Moten. For Syracuse, at guard, a 6-foot sophomore from Washington, D.C., number 20, Sherman Douglas. For Florida, at guard, a 6-4 junior from Gainesville, Florida, number 11, Vernon Maxwell. At guard, a 6'3 senior from Rochester, New York, number 11, Greg Monroe. And now introducing the head coaches. For Florida, in his 13th season, Norm Slow. For Syracuse, in his 11th season, Jim Boeheim.
So we will be set to go. Syracuse against Florida. Coming up. University of Florida comes in with a record of 23-10. Syracuse at 28-6. The referee who will toss up the basketball, Jim Bain of Decatur, Illinois. He'll be working with Nolan Fine of Virginia Beach, Virginia, and Rusty Herring of Durham, North Carolina. The tap is won by Syracuse. Do not be misled. They are wearing the white uniforms. The Gators will be in the orange, so perhaps I should not refer to Syracuse as the Orangemen here tonight, Philip.
Brent, they start off in a zone defense, so you know who to look for. Monroe with his three-pointer. If you haven't played against Monroe a lot, you'd be surprised how quickly he gets it off.
Lawrence picking him up on the wing in their zone over here, and they rotate to Douglas. Schintzius, a 7'2" center, and Trish up over him with the game's first basket.
Nice move by Syracuse to come right in behind the zone. That's an open area against a 2-3.
Andrew Moten, 5'11" is Vernon Maxwell, giving it up to Joe Lawrence, who is 4. His brother Pat over on the Gator bench. Moten hangs and ties it.
Shows you why he has been such a prolific scorer. He just double clutched it. There's a 2-1-2 zone.
The Gators.
2-1-2 zone press. Monroe not looking for that shot at all.
Douglas with a 3. Spins out. Coleman with a strong offensive rebound. A key player in this game.
Could be, Brent. He has not played well of late, particularly on the offensive end. Needs to get off to a big start. Big change in matchup right here. Trish on Maxwell. So they put a forward on him, trying to get a little bit more size.
Maxwell's first shot, but it's rebounded by Jones. And Seikaly's first rejection, and here's Monroe. The general whips one to Seikaly. He moves in and travels.
That's one of those premeditated moves by Rony Seikaly. Didn't get good position, got himself off balance, no place to go. How often do we see Douglas come back in there and make a steal on that inbounds pass?
Making Moten work to come across the timeline.
Keep an eye on Trish and Maxwell. Interesting matchup here.
Schintzius out high. Jump pass. Great passer. Shows you why Jones blows the layup. Douglas on the move. Trish again short with a shot. Douglas with the rebound. High arch. Won't stay down. Banged by Coleman. Schintzius first rejection. And Jones comes out for the game. Well, Monroe back on defense, so is Trish.
Moten is not a guy that likes to dish the ball off. He's taking it in for the score. Might have been a walk on Schintzius.
Boy, Schintzius is a good passer for someone who's 7'2". And Joe Lawrence outside hits the first three. He's a bomber from the perimeter.
Joe Lawrence.
Lawrence, a great shooter. Most of his baskets will come on threes. Very seldom goes inside on the dribble. That's why Monroe can probably handle him.
Florida leading by a point, just underway here in the first half, 5-4. Clean, well-played game so far. Douglas on the penetration, gets his first field goal.
Douglas has no fear when he goes on the inside. I don't care who's in there to block his shot.
Syracuse takes the lead, 6-5.
Exactly what we expected, Brent. Two teams going to really go up and down his floor. You'd expect a score in the 90s.
Coleman fronting Melvin Jones. He has a height advantage. It's going to be tough to get the ball into him if he continues that kind of defensive pressure in front of him.
What helps, though, Schintzius is an excellent passer from the post.
Seikaly moved over toward the ball but did not touch it. It'll go over to Syracuse. Billy, what about that battle in the middle between Seikaly and Schintzius?
So far, it looks to me like it's a standoff. Neither player getting good post position. Schintzius a better passer. Rony Seikaly probably a better power man inside.
You saw Chris Capers and Ronnie Montgomery check in early for Norm Sloan. Billy, are the Florida Gators a little deeper than Syracuse?
Quite a bit deeper, and they'll use all 10 fellas for Syracuse. It may be a bad team like looking at Georgetown.
Is a decided Florida tinge to Coach Sloan's team. Now, that's a man who won a national championship with North Carolina State back in the 70s.
Excuse me, Brent, what North Sloan was asking for, he felt that last ball was tipped inside.
Seikaly jams it.
Schintzius really cannot get in a situation where he leaves that area because Seikaly lost the lob from Douglas.
8-5, Syracuse leading. Schintzius. Jump hook is short. Capers underneath scores.
Capers, an explosive player off the bench. Not only does Norm Sloan use these fellas, but he gets great production from his bench.
three. Schintzius hands the ball over. And Montgomery, the pure point man, brings it down. He has Maxwell on the right side. Joe Lawrence stayed in. Capers replaced Jones. So, in effect, Moten and Jones are out in this rotation. The great athlete, Vernon Maxwell, sticks one, his first field goal from the baseline. You can watch the pressure being exerted from above.
You see the full court press. It's a zone press. A lot of quick athletes out there, and Florida has prevented teams from getting over that 10-second line five times this year. How about that play?
Again, in low to Ronnie Seikaly, who has jammed in two field goals.
Well, in that zone, Schintzius is going to have to move back and protect that area around the basket. He's up a little high, so they're throwing right over his head.
Joe Lawrence, the three up over the top and out, and go on over to Syracuse. We have a timeout, a television timeout, at the 14:48 mark. Syracuse leading Florida by a point.
Bobby Knight will try to motivate Steve Alford and Indiana past Duke. The number one ranked UNLV faces Wyoming. Regional semifinal action continues tomorrow night on CBS Sports.
Ronnie Seikaly, who attended the American School in Athens, Greece, came to basketball late in his athletic career, has hit for two slams, and what does it mean for Dwayne Schintzius here tonight?
Well, in that particular play, fans were keeping a close look, and I can see that Dwayne Schintzius was in no man's land in the zone. He's either got to play back to stop that lob or move up a little bit to stop the penetration, but he's in no man's land, and now Florida goes the man-to-man.
And Maxwell comes on out on Douglas, as you predicted would happen here, Billy. Coleman left alone in the middle. He has a mismatch at any man-to-man they want to throw.
Capers just letting go right on by like he was waving a wand. And if Coleman can get this kind of start, he's going to gain a lot of confidence. Now Syracuse goes zone, so the two teams have changed their defenses, flip-flopping back and forth.
Maxwell's three. Not there. Seikaly rebound.
Brent Seikaly looks like the maturity factor is really significant over Schintzius at this point.
It's Coleman again coming high. Seikaly down low, but there was a whistle. And our first foul is called against Joe Lawrence. His brother will soon check in.
Brother for brother, Pat going in. Now there's the reach by Schintzius. So far today, Brent, he has really showed some signs of freshman immaturity in the fact that he was out of position in both cases. There's a brother for brother, Pat in for Joe.
Trish has his man go down. On the switch comes in, Seikaly on the turnaround, hits the jumper. Three field goals for Ronnie Seikaly in the early going.
And two for Coleman. So the Syracuse big guys really starting to take advantage.
As a result, Syracuse leading 14-9. Pat Lawrence bangs the two. Knocked away from Douglas. Gators come down. Three on two as Monroe hurries back. And the pass is off Capers out of bounds on the turnover over to Syracuse.
Good pass by Moten that time. Capers probably should have been prepared to catch that ball. Kind of swift, but he could have had it.
Kenny McClary, the 6'8", 7th center. He'll replace Dwayne Schintzius, who will sit down on the Florida bench. McClary, a junior.
And small at 6'7", so you're seeing Florida with a very small ball club out there. Let's see if Syracuse tries to go up over the top.
Syracuse has hit five of their last six shots, stolen by Moten. Let's see if they can get something going on this break.
That's a kick by Douglas.
Florida's ball as a result.
Well, you see Norm Sloan has really made so many different changes here that he really has an entirely different type of ball club to play against on the floor right now. Small but extremely quick.
McClary comes underneath, stepped out of bounds. Billy, they have turned the ball over on their last two trips. They haven't gotten a shot down.
Seem very uncomfortable, kind of out of sync. I think they may be surprised at the athletic ability of Syracuse so far in this game.
Seikaly, four field goals here in the first half.
Brent, this club on the floor for Florida is too small to play the Syracuse team that's out there right now. Syracuse packing in their 2-3 zone.
Maxwell loses
quick he is. Normally, Douglas outraces everybody to the ball.
The three is not there, and Trish rebounds, looks outlet.
Seikaly. Oh, Douglas, what a great play. That was the only thing he could do. It looked like an easy interception.
7-point lead, the biggest so far by Syracuse.
Trish threw it in no man's land. Looks like an easy play to intercept for Moten. Instead, Douglas goes over and does the only thing possible and taps it off to Seikaly.
Billy Coach Sloan sent in Melvin Jones, who's 6'5", Joe Lawrence, 6'6", and Clifford Lett, who is 6'3". Ronnie Seikaly has taken a big lead in that center duel. Schintzius over on the bench.
Well, Coach Sloan has taken teams all the way to the Final Four. He did it with a guy named Tommy Burleson, who did an outstanding job in the national championship. Right now, he needs some more size in his ballgame.
He could be giving Schintzius a rest right now, talking to him on the side. He has him back up, and he will send the 7-2 center back into the game, trying perhaps to settle the young man down in the early going, because Seikaly's experience is giving him a big edge. Now, remember, we talk about Ronnie Seikaly. As I said at the top of the broadcast, he's been in that pit against the likes of Patrick Ewing, David Robinson, knocked away in a foul call. Goes against Trish. This is an idea of the top men Seikaly has played against. Patrick Ewing when he was at Georgetown, Walter Berry at St. John's, David Robinson of the Naval Academy, Purvis Ellison of Louisville. Seikaly said, "I can't believe how they're building up a freshman to this proportion when I've played against centers such as that." Coach Jim Boeheim of Syracuse telling me, "I can't believe that Florida is favored in this game." But they are by the narrowest of margins, a point.
You know, when he's happy is when he looks most disturbed. You know, he's just looking over there up at the ceiling. He has to like what he sees so far in his ballgame.
McCleary's free throw falls to make it an 18-13 game. But all eyes on the coaching bench of Florida will have to be on Schintzius. And he was guarding him too closely. Clifford Lett, his first personal of the game. Lett is a 6'3 sophomore out of Pensacola, Florida.
What's really interesting is every player in this Florida club comes from the state of Florida. I don't know if there's another team in the top 16 that can make that statement.
Stevie Thompson checks in for Syracuse. Boeheim is not deep, and he'll tell you it doesn't matter come NCAA time. You depend on those five regulars down the stretch. He didn't get a single point off his bench, I don't believe, for the last couple of games. Loose. And Schintzius comes up with it for the Gators. That's five turnovers by Syracuse.
Good defensive transition by Syracuse.
Moten on the double team. McCleary will send it over. And Lott gets it to fall on the roll.
Good athlete.
I think I said Lott. Let me correct myself. I was thinking of Ronnie Lott, the great defensive back. This is Lett, L-E-T-T.
Florida seems to be more effective in the man-to-man defense now. In a little better positioning. There's a good example.
Good move by Schintzius.
Right.
Knocks the ball out of bounds.
They started out in the zone and were a little lethargic, so I think a very good move by Coach Sloan to go ahead and get to the man-to-man, get his team moving their feet a little bit.
Gators down, but only by 3 points.
Nice fake.
Coleman, jumper outside. And going into him was Kenny McCleary. His first personal. And the third against the team. Three team fouls on Florida and only one against Syracuse. And we have played 10 minutes.
Coleman was the Big East Freshman of the Year. He was set up in the preseason to be that and carried it out throughout the course of the season. Maxwell back into the ball game. Lett takes his seat. Well,
play so far, despite the size disadvantage and the obvious matchup problems that Coach Sloan faces, his team still very much in this contest here in the first half.
I think they're in the ball game, but I'm really surprised at how much bigger Syracuse is playing than Florida. You know, in the SEC, they have a lot of outstanding athletes. A lot of that we saw Auburn just the other week. We know what Alabama's got down there. We saw how well LSU went up on the boards. And right now, Syracuse is kind of dominating the inside game. They're playing a lot bigger than Florida.
Derrick Brower checked in. Seikaly out for the time being for Boeheim. Maxwell gave it up. Schintzius passing underneath, but Clary can't get at the ball. Florida has missed three layups that I can remember. Coleman forces one that time.
Good rebound by McClure. Listed at 210 earlier in the season. It's got to be 240.
Moulton threw the foul, slashing to the basket over on the baseline. Thompson's first personal and the second team foul against Syracuse.
Right now, Brent, I think Florida is starting themselves a little bit out of sync. Of course, they use a lot of players, so they should be accustomed to playing with different combinations. But you can see they're coming down and not a lot is working into play.
Sykes returned for Syracuse. Douglas and Coleman sit down.
Second team All-SEC for the past 2 years, was the freshman of the year in the conference's first year. After his sophomore year, despite good stats, almost left the University of Florida.
We have a television timeout near the 10-minute mark, and we'll be right back. Orange juice. They're out of the Orangemen, right? I asked Coach Norm Sloan, what's his recipe for success in the NCAA?
Everybody has to raise their level of play to a point that probably they haven't experienced before. I mean, you just have to start, and I keep preaching that over and over. You have to do things better than you've ever done them before. And every now and then I'll step in and say, you know, Joe or Pat or whatever it is, you haven't made anything happen in a while here. And they look at you kind of funny, but that's what has to take place.
Well, Moulton just did it. He made something take place. Maxwell could not get it to fall on the other side, but Florida has another opportunity. Moulton resets the play for the Gators.
But they're down four, and that's two uncontested layups they've missed. I get a feeling that Syracuse is way ahead of this game. And I look up at the scoreboard.
They rejected Schintzius.
That'll take away some confidence from a freshman. Schintzius used to talk a lot about his ability. Vernon Sloan has calmed that down a little bit.
Seikaly goes to the glass, counts the basket. That's 12 points already for Seikaly. He was banged by McClary inside.
Now here's Schintzius trying to go out. Good push off by Ronnie Seikaly. Could have almost been a foul, but it looks like he's a lot more powerful to be able to go ahead and move Schintzius that easily. McClary came over, didn't get there in time. Seikaly off to a big game here.
Sherman Douglas returning for Syracuse. Seikaly gets the free throw to fall. That's 13 points, and Schintzius yet to score in this game. The inside scoring the difference so far. Schintzius taps one in there. He breaks the schneid at the 8:24 mark, first half.
Moulton sitting right down with Douglas, so they've changed that defensive assignment. Syracuse playing basically with their three-guard offense now. Boy, Moulton is quick.
He sure is. Knocked another one out of bounds. So Billy Packer and I are here at the Meadowlands in East Rutherford, New Jersey. We are watching the East Regional Semifinal between Florida of the Southeastern Conference and Syracuse of the Big East. 23-18, Syracuse leading, and Pat Lawrence checks back in for the Gators. He is number three. So the two Lawrences are out there. Moulton has a hand all over the ball.
Has a great feel for that lob pass. He was looking straight ahead and anticipated Seikaly coming from the backside. There aren't many players in the country doing any better than Sherman Douglas. Good job by Brower to come out on the shooter.
Maxwell's three.
smooth. What do they say in the West Coast? Easy.
Easy out, according to Wyoming. The trap on Monroe. Oh, Douglas breaks for the glass. Pretty looking play against that trap.
Brent, you talked about the bench. Brower's the kind of guy you want to come off the bench. He's solid, not going to make many bad plays.
Milton's three. That's back-to-back threes by the M&M boys.
Monroe doesn't want to dribble against his press very often.
Seikaly wants to go to work on the freshman again. Stays with it, and Schintzius is right there with him. Taps it in, Seikaly. That's 17 first half points for center Rony Seikaly. And Sloan is all over referee Main as he passes the bench.
He should have been. Rony Seikaly walked almost twice on that play. Good pass. It was a great idea. That's where Schintzius is tough, right at the top of the foul line, passing inside.
Derrick Coleman of Detroit returns, and Howard Frisch from Syracuse also checks back into Boeheim's lineup. What we have seen is Brower play center and forward, and a rotation as Boeheim rests his regulars here. We have 6:37 to go in the first half. Frisch is alone. Schintzius came out.
No basket. No basket.
But he was in over, but nothing is called.
Should have been no basket.
Throws it in at the other end. Now that field goal counted. That's 18 points for Seikaly in the first half. He could get his career high, which is 29, and that's what Schintzius feared yesterday at his news conference. Douglas on the loose.
Maxwell's got Loden all alone.
Let's take a look at that replay, Billy, that you didn't think should have counted.
Now, we'll see if this ball's not in a cylinder. Going up. That's no basket. You can't touch the ball when any part of that ball is in the cylinder of the basket. But guess what? It counted.
As a result, it's 31-26, but it's the Florida right there.
Syracuse getting a lot of ball handling by people other than Douglas against the press.
Coleman turns the other way, and Schintzius says, take that.
Now, that was a frustration block by Schintzius, because all he had to do, he knew that he had his man centered here. All he had to do is get control of this ball. It made no sense to smack it all the way out of bounds.
What a great future someone has who's 7-2 to play like that, but he's still learning. Douglas spins, and he traveled. On the turnover, which is the seventh by Syracuse in this half, it will go over. And Coach Sloan reinserts Rony Montgomery at the point from Jacksonville.
Sloan working those officials pretty good. He's one of the best in the business at it. Sitting next to Monty Tao, another one of those fellas that played back in 74 for Sloan when North Carolina State won the championship.
Only two team fouls against Syracuse with 5:28 to go and four against Florida.
And none of them on Seikaly. And what did Schintzius say? He was going to get him in foul trouble.
Goes over though, offensive foul.
Good job by Monroe. Syracuse gets out of their zone, goes back to man-to-man.
And what did Seikaly say? Easier said than done, big fella, to get me an early foul trouble. So Rony Seikaly has played quite well here. He's more experienced, and that certainly has given him an edge.
Coleman showing what a ball handler he is.
Monroe gives it up. Knocked out of bounds and goal. That's the eighth turnover here in the first half. 5:09 to go. Syracuse 31, Florida 26, and Moten coming back in to run things along with Montgomery. They'll have two point guards, and they'll operate with three guards in this lineup because Maxwell stays in. He'll go up against Frisch at that number three or small forward spot.
You notice how Jimmy Boeheim's changed his defense. I think it gives Syracuse a lot more flexibility. Nice pass.
And Schintzius with a good soft touch inside. Not a real easy shot. Looks easy sometimes.
Douglas splits the trap.
Douglas fires it out of bounds. That's nine turnovers by Syracuse. So we're close to the five-minute mark. That's the third television break. What we're allowed, and we'll be right back. Press.
Yeah, here's the press, and here is why Trish got wide open. Joe Lawrence goes out to double team, but you can't double team from that big a distance. Now Trish puts up the shot. This is the shot I said Seikaly caught on the downward arc as it was above the cylinder. Was credited as a basket, probably shouldn't have been. This game is close enough as it is.
If Florida hits a three, they would tie it.
Well, they don't have but four guys out there that can shoot it effectively. Lawrence can shoot it, Maxwell can shoot it, Montgomery can shoot it, and Moten can shoot it. But they're playing a real tough man-to-man defense now, so it's hard to get room for that three. There he goes.
One down, and he stepped on the line. A fresh start for the Florida Gators.
Moten showing some real range. He's got great elevation on his legs to get that shot off. You know, like in so many sports, your legs generate the power, whether it be golf and in basketball shooting a shot. Guys that get that spring have a lot of power in the three-pointer.
Here's Schintzius. And again, Florida, three-pointer. Moten not there. And finally, Syracuse comes away.
With all the quickness that Florida has, when you get an offensive rebound, you can't just dish it out there quickly. And Syracuse's fellas are running away from that pass. It's going to cost them.
Monroe, still not on the scoreboard. Cycling. And Schintzius tied up inside. And that will be foul number one on Rony Cycling. With 3:45 to go here in the first half, a summation of this game will show you how Syracuse has blazed away from the field, especially inside with Seikaly shooting all those layups. Moten leading Florida with 8 points, and the Gators come back down with an opportunity to tie it with a three. Schintzius loses it on the turnover. Coleman comes out. Moten is back quickly.
Good decision by Coleman that time. He was almost going to challenge Moten. Wisely did not.
Trish gets it back to Douglas, who got inside, and Montgomery blasted the ball from above out of bounds. Good defensive move for Coach Sloan.
Montgomery's been hampered by injuries all year. Had an infected foot, knee problem early in the year.
Douglas with an offensive rebound, in with the trees. And Schintzius has it wind up right his stomach. Outlet to Maxwell. Maxwell coming through, misses another layup. And Pat Lawrence collides with Coleman, and the foul is against Lawrence. Reminder of what we've coming up for you tomorrow night here on CBS. Many of you will see Indiana against Duke. We'll also be covering Oklahoma, Iowa. And in the late night game, live from Seattle, the Runnin' Rebels against the True Cinderella, Wyoming. That's all tomorrow night on CBS. Here's Douglas. Seikaly.
That is what, number four lob for baskets by Douglas?
It has been a long first half for Dwayne Schintzius so far. Seikaly yanking it away on the outlet. Monroe gets it into Trish's hands. Got the shooter's roll. That's his second field goal. 2:19. It's 35-28.
So far in the tournament, Florida has had those blitzes where they've blown away from NC State and then against Purdue. Right now, it's Syracuse. One more run like this, and even with 2 minutes to go, Coach Sloan may be thinking about slowing them down with a timeout.
Florida has missed its last five shots. Moten left alone. Now it's six. And Lawrence coming down was fouled by Douglas. His first personal.
Second good rebound inside by Lawrence, not known for his rebounding. Did a good job. Played at Crestview High in Florida with
Maxwell
his brother.
Sitting down. Clifford Lett checked back into the game.
And Brent, another guy on that high school ball club, Tommy Hammonds from Georgia Tech. Can you imagine three players of that caliber on a high school team?
That comparison, very one-sided.
Syracuse using their front court players to beat the press.
Coleman coming through the personal foul. Schintzius' second here in the first half. And they will be shooting. Florida with 17 fouls. They've gone to the 1-1. Syracuse with 14 fouls. But he will have two because he was shooting the layup that time. Even though they are over the limit the rest of the way, you're going to have two here for Coleman.
On the year, Florida was exactly even with their opponents in rebounding.
Not a good Clary returning.
Right, not a good sign if you're playing against a team like Syracuse, which is an excellent rebounding club.
Get up! Gotta go!
Trish helps out on Lawrence. Pat Lawrence with a three.
3-point basket by Pat Lawrence.
Both Lawrence boys, excellent students and really good at that 3-point range.
So the four threes here keep the Gators in it in the first half. Syracuse 0 for 2 from 3-point land. Douglas coming through with a nice move.
He was actually tripped up and still made the play. Has excellent balance.
McClary gets inside.
Walk.
No basket. He tried it.
A little delay call there, but it is absolutely on the money. And Seikaly and Coleman inside intimidating a little bit for Florida on those drives. We know Maxwell's missed one. Actually, two.
Douglas spins inside, gets it to Seikaly, and Rony Seikaly, 23 first half points against Norm Sloan. That moves him within six of his career high.
Douglas doing a lot of early breakaway stuff in this ball game. Right now, I think Florida misses Maxwell's offense.
Job of drawing that foul on Rony Seikaly too. His second here in the first half. Schintzius picked up two.
Seikaly's going to come out right now. Brower going back in there. Jim Boeheim with only 12 seconds to go. Sure doesn't want Seikaly to pick up his third. Had a great first half.
Talking about Maxwell, Billy. 2 of 8 here in the first half. And Moten, 2 of 7. So that's 4 of 15 from the M&M boys.
You see Moten on the foul line has a very unusual foul shooting technique with his feet. They stay planted on the floor, back on his heels. Normally a fellow get a little bit of a rocker motion there.
Against Montgomery pressure, Douglas gets it inside, and he traveled. And again, it is not called. Douglas is three. Buzzer, that's it. The end of the first half. Syracuse behind Rony Seikaly's 23 points takes a 40-33 lead over Florida. CBS Sports coverage of the NCAA basketball tournament continues after this message and a word from your local stations.
CBS Sports coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship is sponsored by State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Cadillac Motor Car Division and your Cadillac dealer. Best of all, it's a Cadillac. And by Gillette Foamy Shave Cream for sensitive skin.
In progress here in the East Regional, Game 1, and Syracuse leading Florida 40-33. Meanwhile, down in the Southeast Regional, and that's the first semifinal, Providence with a 4-point lead on Alabama, 38-34. One of the things we want to do in this halftime is tell you more about the Florida team. They really came out of nowhere to get into the NCAA. Billy Cunningham with more on that story.
The University of Florida has never had much trouble getting folks excited about their football team. The football stadium on Saturday afternoon in the fall is always packed with Gator fans. But this year, there's a new wrinkle in Gainesville as their indoor arena is packed for a different sport. Basketball is hot and heavy among fans in the media in Gatorland, something Coach Norm Sloan thought wouldn't happen unless drastic measures were taken.
All they've ever known is football. I have a tendency to put my foot in my mouth a lot, but somebody said, asked me the same question. What do you think it's going to take to change the media's perception of basketball in the league? I said, a few timely funerals will help. Oh, boy, several people got mad. I didn't name any names, you know, but some people took it personal.
But Sloan took it personal in his first stint at Florida as coach back in the 60s when he felt the university wasn't supporting his team. So he left for Raleigh, North Carolina, where he built a powerhouse at North Carolina State behind the great David Thompson and floor general Monty Tau. The Wolfpack ended UCLA's string of seven straight NCAA titles. When Florida called for Sloan to come back and build their program in 1980, many were surprised he accepted.
My wife, to the day we were moving furniture out of the house, didn't believe we were going to leave. I mean, it took her 2 years to get over it, and I guess she's over it. I'm not sure. But anyhow, I love the state, and I love the position of this university in the state, the Southeastern Conference, the high school talent in this state, and I just thought it would be a great job.
While the return of Norm Sloan to the University of Florida has brought success to the Gators basketball program, it's been the infusion of this supercharged candy into the lineup that has the fans here in Gainesville expecting that their first NCAA tournament bid will not melt in their hands. They're the M&M twins, and if you haven't heard of them before, you will in the tournament. Vernon Maxwell, a 6'4 guard, and backcourt mate Andrew Moten, who's the floor leader. Their admiration for each other is mutual.
Oh, it's real great playing with Vernon. I think Vernon a real talented athlete. Got a very explosive first step, and, you know, this has been fun my last 3 years here with Vernon.
It's a good feeling just, you know, just having him on my side, you know, to play with him, you know, because he does a lot of great things on the court, and sometimes I just find myself watching him play.
They've also been watching 7'2 freshman Dwayne Schintzius, the type of blue-chip Florida high school prospect Sloan had trouble landing in the past.
The perception was that Florida had never had basketball and was never going to have basketball, and if you're an outstanding high school player in the state of Florida, the thing to do is go out of the state to one of the named schools in the country. I think Dwayne's the first player, Billy, that we really had to compete on a national level to get that we won the recruiting battle on.
It's close to home, and, you know, I'm kind of a mama's boy and all, and, you know, my parents like to watch me play basketball, and another reason is I'd like to help keep other great players in the state of Florida, too.
So with the horses to run the race, the Gators lack only tournament experience to win. Assistant Monty Tau, who came with Sloan from NC State, hopes the coaches can provide that.
Coach Sloan represents tradition. I feel like that I represent tradition. We know what it takes to get to the NCAA tournament. We know just how tough and how lucky and how good you have to be to win the NCAA tournament.
And Sloan's advice to his players is simple. Just keep doing what got you this far.
Don't fall into that old thing of having trouble breathing and so forth, and guys, let's hope we don't make a mistake. Jack it up if you're open, and let's get out and press them and run, and let's be an exciting team. I think that's the way you win championships in postseason play.
Okay, it's a basketball school. I open up my mail today. I figure I got the latest from the University of Florida, the basketball team. Spring football is in the air. Still king, I think, down there. We're going to come back, talk with Billy Backer more, and we continue from the East Region semifinal in a moment. Hello, Gator. How you doing? Syracuse dominating inside, leading Florida 40-33. Billy Packer's second game's a dandy. The Tar Heels of North Carolina against the Fighting Irish.
Well, as opposed to this game, it's really a game of contrast. You have one club that really wants to keep this thing slowed down. You've got another that scored twice over 100 so far in the NCAA tournament, and they'd like to explode out of there, and that's what's going to be the key.
Digger Phelps of Notre Dame matched against Dean Smith of North Carolina. And yesterday after practice, Billy had an opportunity to talk to the two about the matchup.
Digger, how tough to beat a team like North Carolina twice same year?
I think our kids are ready. They know what to expect. They know not many people believe we can beat them again. They thought it was a fluke the first time, especially with Kenny Smith being out of the game. But I think we've been goofy all year, and we can do it again.
What kind of a game do you want? What kind of a pace?
Obviously, we can't score 90 or 100. For us, the win has got to be 50-60s. That's the type of tempo we want, and that's the type of tempo we will create. If they want to up-tempo the game, then when we have the shots against their traps, we'll take it to score. But I think we have to control the game tempo.
Notre Dame's got to try to slow it down against you, not get into an up-tempo game. You as a coach will try to change that defensively. Is that going to be?
You know, you can't do that with good athletes. Like Rivers has the ball, what are we going to do? Go out and let him go by for a layup? Actually, they play everybody that way. They played Central Michigan that way. They played Kansas. That's their game. And, you know, the teams that do that are in any game. They don't blow people out very often, but they're in every game, and it's not a bad way to play. I personally enjoy fast breaking and playing pressure defense, and that's why our team does it. But I think the score will probably be in the 50s.
Can the Tar Heels win it all? North Carolina, Notre Dame coming up after the second half of Florida Syracuse. We'll return to the Meadowlands Arena in East Rutherford, New Jersey, after this message and a word from your local station. Coverage of the Championship is sponsored by the Heartbeat of America, today's Chevrolet. Unisys, the combined power of Sperry and Burroughs. Unisys, the power of two. And by Minolta, creator of the incredible Maxim Autofocus SLR system. Only from the mind of Minolta.
We are in the shadow of the Big Apple across the Hudson River here. East Rutherford, New Jersey, in the Meadowlands Complex. And we'll get ready to start the second half with Syracuse leading Florida. And I'll tell you what, Rony Seikaly has taken Dwayne Schintzius to school here in the first half of this game. That's the big edge so far in the ball game. 23-4. Seikaly has hit 11 of his 14 shots. What about the second half, Billy?
Well, Brent, that issue has been decided right there. I mean, I never expected that type of dominance, and a freshman is in for a very rough night. The key in the second half has got to be, okay, how does Florida compensate for this? Cycley's off to a monster game. They've got to compensate by the M&M boys, Maxwell and Moten, and they have not actually torn it up here in the first half. Moten with 10 points and Maxwell with 5, but they're not shooting that much, and they're not really dominating the game in the backcourt. If Florida's going to win this, they're going to have to do it with a three-pointer in the backcourt domination of those two players, if they can do it. That remains to be seen. Actually, in the three-point shots, Florida's leading 12-0, and if it wasn't for that, they'd be totally out of this ballgame.
Billy, if you had a young man like Schintzius, what would you have told him at the half? He's only a freshman.
Well, you know, I don't think that he's wiped out mentally in a ball game like this. I think you'd have to talk to him about some of the technical things that he's doing incorrectly. His positioning has been poor, and he's been in no man's land so much on defense, it's allowed Seikaly really to get a lot of easy baskets.
Billy, how'd they do against North Carolina State and Purdue in the second half?
Well, I mentioned in the first half they've had some super blowout situations. NC State in the second half, they scored 49. Against Purdue, they had 54. And considering those two ball clubs, particularly Purdue, to score 54 points against a Purdue club in the second half is amazing. And one of the things Norm Sloan counts on is that deep bench, but I don't see Syracuse being tired at all.
We have concentrated a lot this halftime on Florida. I am impressed with the coaching job that Jim Boeheim has done with this Syracuse team here tonight.
Well, you remember the last time we saw him in person, the Big East Final. I thought his club kind of looked like a dog there in the second half when Georgetown kept coming on with relentless pressure. They look a lot more confident today. And I think the changing of defenses on his part, not showing them all zone, giving them a little man-to-man, has really helped his club.
Florida in the orange jerseys, Syracuse in the white. Maxwell off the penetration, hits the first field goal of the second half.
That's Byrne Maxwell.
Florida with its starting lineup out there, with the exception of Kenny McClary, now operating with Dwayne Schintzius. Loose, Moten comes away, Trish rotates defensively. That's back-to-back layups, and Boeheim may use an early timeout.
I don't think he'll go to it right yet, but there's the M&M starting right off. A steal and two baskets.
They close back to within three.
Maxwell on Monroe. Monroe really has to be careful when he puts the ball down the floor, because Maxwell has a lot of advantage on him quickness-wise.
Seikaly got Schintzius back up in the air on that.
What did we have at the top of the show where Schintzius said, I'm going to give him some head fakes to get him off the ground? And there again, Schintzius in no man's land. If he's going to get caught on the top, he's got to come over in front on Seikaly. He takes the little pump fake, picks up another foul, and that's his third. Norm Sloan going to the bench again.
And Pat Lawrence checks in. He replaces his brother, his older brother, Joe. Joe is the senior, and Pat Lawrence, number three, the junior. Seikaly can't complete the three-point play. Trish taking Maxwell. Schintzius trying to hit Lawrence, and Coleman with that great quickness hits inside, and three field goals for the M&M boys. 14 points for Moten overall in the game.
Had Douglas not blocking out that time, felt the play was over. Nice pass by Rony Seikaly. Was off balance, got rid of it rather than walking.
Coleman. Quick rejection by McCleary in the sky to block that ball out of bounds.
McCleary not really that good a leaper. Now he and Coleman mouthing off a little bit. If I'm Coleman, I get out of the lane right here. Smart move by Rony Seikaly. There's where you want that experienced veteran. Calm a freshman down. Coleman loses that scrap, I can tell you. I don't care if he's from the Motor City. He's going to be laying on his back on that one.
And Syracuse would lose someone in a fight with 6'9". They can afford to lose their big power forward. Knocked away, run down by Manuel.
Coleman wants the ball.
Trish coming, and Pat Lawrence was hand-checking him. He drew the personal foul. That's his second.
Referees would be smart to keep an eye on McCleary. But he's chasing Coleman around a little bit. That'd be a pretty good swap for Florida. Last year, McCleary had to play the center position in the SEC. Tough.
Gets it back. Douglas in low with the threes. Schintzius comes out. Here's Maxwell in the middle. Goes all the way for the layup. The M&M boys starting to light it up here for the Gators, and Jim Boeheim will use that early timeout.
42-41.
Syracuse calls a timeout. Florida closes to within a point.
Tonight on CBS Sports.
Billy Boeheim was upset by a mental error here.
Well, Sherman Douglas feels he can score against anybody. This was a play that it would have been a lot better for him to get the ball out of there or go for the bounce pass inside to Seikaly. Schintzius did a good job just staying up there and not coming down with a chop. Here's the press. Jimmy Boeheim moving Douglas back to fight against the press instead of releasing early, realizing he wants to get into his offense now, get the big guys back in the game.
Monroe spins free. He has been quiet here tonight. That's his first field goal.
The referee has hurt his ankle.
That's Jim Bain. He's limping over to the sideline. That would bring the alternate, Tim Higgins, into this game if he can't make it.
Jim Bain has been, and he's over there talking with Hank Nichols.
There is Higgins.
Alternate says, I'm not ready.
We may have a referee out here warming up. Meanwhile, while we've got a break here, let me remind you again what's in action tomorrow. And that's the Midwest, Indiana and Duke, and then out west, Oklahoma against Iowa. You'll see coverage of those two games. And then live from the west in Seattle, UNLV, the Running Rebels, against Wyoming. Jim Bain from Decatur, Illinois.
You know that
receiving some attention.
That the fellow that was over there with the striped shirt is really a scorer, not a referee. So that maybe they're going to. Where is the alternate official seated right now?
Billy, I get word that Higgins. That is not Higgins.
No.
Higgins went out into the hallway and he is warming up. Out behind the arena, there is a long hallway that extends past the various locker rooms, and he is back there jogging. Starting to loosen up, doing some stretching exercises in the shadow.
That looks like the kind of exercises I do if that's warming up.
You're next, Billy, if they lose another official.
Well, I've always wanted to try.
Yeah, you really have, haven't you?
I wonder if I'd get the 350 they get paid if I went out there. Which, you know, if you want to editorialize a little bit, I think the officials ought to get paid a little more than 350 considering the importance of these games.
Thank
17-29 left in regulation. Syracuse leading Florida 44-41. We'll take a break while we get an opportunity. Meanwhile, Higgins will continue to loosen up. Now he comes to the front. He'll be ready when we return. Billy, what becomes now of Hank Nichols there in the middle?
Well, Hank was observing this tournament, obviously, and he is one of the most respected guys, worked seven Final Fours, and I guess he's going to move into the alternative position now. And here's the new official working. Tim Higgins, he was the alternate. Now Hank, I guess, is going to take on the responsibilities of the alternate. Syracuse goes zone.
44-41, Syracuse over Florida, 17-11 left. Maxwell's three off the glass.
He'll take it.
Has tied it at 44 with 17 minutes to go. Trish back for Syracuse. Schintzius outlet. Here's Maxwell on a breakaway. Florida may take the lead, and they do.
M&M boys is at their 12th point of the half. They had a run of 17-0 against NC State. 44.
Two field goals in the second half. Greg Monroe. Florida is perfect here in the second half with the M&M boys. They are 6 of 6. And Norm Sloan seems to have settled in to a 5. Maxwell's 3. That first miss off glass. And Pat Lawrence gets it back. Milton jacks the 3. And a foul inside.
There's a case of Douglas. Seeing the screen by Lawrence, instead of going around to try to get to his man, tries to push through. That's his second. Pat Lawrence, that's about his third or fourth rebound. He's not a big rebounder, but doing a job tonight. He's had a good nose for the ball.
The threes are the difference here so far as Florida is concerned.
It's just open inside.
What a side jump hook.
Freshman's having a rough night.
Douglas wants to get the ball.
Bolton's quickness is kind of amazing, and he's right with Douglas.
Goes to the ground. And McCurry with a hand on it. Outlet to Moulton. Maxwell over on the right. Moulton's going to go the distance. Oh, it's a two-point Gator lead again.
M&M is now 16 for the half. See Syracuse starting to get out of their tempo a little bit, Brent. The momentum is really swinging around a little bit. They got to get back in their offense, get their inside game going.
Florida is capable of going on incredible runs. Seikaly short. Schintzius into the hands of Maxwell. They lit up Jimmy Valvano. Lawrence's three not there, but Schintzius with a hand, and McCleary comes back inside on Seikaly. The foul is called, and that's the third on Rony Seikaly. This game has changed completely here in the second half.
It really has. The inside dominance of Syracuse, being patient enough to go inside instead of worrying about the perimeter game, really helped them in the first half. Now they've gotten away from that completely. And for Florida, it shifted back to the two guys that have carried them for the past three seasons, Maxwell and Moten.
Stevie Thompson reports in for Syracuse.
Really,
Douglas sits down.
Interesting substitution here, Brandon. That's going to be for a little tongue lashing. Douglas, you can be sure, is going to be back in this game quickly.
Moten has given Douglas more trouble than any guard we've seen, except Charles Smith of Georgetown. The Harris did pretty good in that game two of the Big East regular season up in the Carrier Dome. I know our fans up in Syracuse remember that contest well.
Is inside for Syracuse.
McCleary picking off Coleman, who was going to come around a cycling screen, and that's his third personal foul.
You know, sometimes powerfully built guys, particularly with their upper body, use their arms, get called for a lot of cheap fouls.
That's McClary's third. He's done a job so far tonight. And here's Capers coming into the game, a fellow who has really exploded off the bench but didn't show much early in the first half.
Florida has outscored Syracuse 16-6 here in the second half, Billy, and Gators build a three-point lead with 14:40 left in regulation. Coleman goes strong. There's that inside game.
That's where Syracuse has got to dominate.
That's Derrick Coleman.
You know what helped? McClary out of the ball game. So Coleman got some confidence against the smaller Gators.
They may have to try Jones back there on Coleman. That's how they started the game. He is not having good luck with that jump hook. But the foul is going to go against Coleman, his first. You know, Higgins steps into this game as the alternate official. Let me just make a quick observation. And the officiating changes. It's a little bit closer inside than it was in the first half.
That's sharp there, Brent. You judged that, and I didn't see that yet. I'm going to have to keep up with it.
Jones is back. It's his pass to Moten, who checks the three. Coleman, stolen by Lawrence. Here's Maxwell. Yanked away by Monroe. Outlets Trish. Over to Seikaly. Bombs away. 27 for Lonnie Seikaly.
Brent, that's what happens when you have guards that are inside rebounding on offense. Moten and Maxwell were both in there. Therefore, no floor balance. Gave up an easy two.
Traveling. Billy, when a guard like Maxwell goes to the glass, as he just did, and he has Pat Lawrence outside him for an easy toss, should he have gone to him for the baseline jumper?
Well, that possibly could have been the play, but with him going inside as much as he is, Lawrence is going to have to swing out some and be out there back defensively. You've got to have balance.
So he should have rotated out when he saw the guard coming in.
Right.
Knocked away from Seikaly. Schintzius playing with three personal fouls. Seikaly with three. Schintzius has been a better performer here in the second half.
He's been a little bit more aggressive, using his body a little bit more to get position.
Stolen almost. Boy, Moten is quick. Hands. Lawrence has him too. Loose. Syracuse's ball.
Pat Lawrence playing a super game here tonight.
Sure is. Monroe coming on in the second half. That's three field goals. He was scoreless in the first.
Norm Sloan cheering on Lawrence over there, telling him he's doing a fine job, which he really is, even though Syracuse was able to score on that turnover.
Moten inside. Schintzius with a good rebound. Couldn't get it to fall. Comes back to the ball. Out of bounds, Syracuse's ball.
The shot. Just let it release a little bit too quickly.
Billy, what about that jump hook? It's somewhat odd looking to me. He gets side saddled now. Is that his normal shot?
Well, he's a great baseball pitcher, or was as a kid growing up. He doesn't have that hook down, and certainly hasn't had it hit tonight.
We've got a timeout called by Norm Sloan. Rony Seikaly has scored 27 points. We asked freshman Dwayne Schintzius yesterday, what's your biggest fear going against Seikaly?
I just have a concern of Rony Seikaly scoring a career high on me. I've been known to have people score career highs on me, you know, in the earlier part of the season. But I'm just going to go out there and play my style of ball. I've been playing real well these past games, and I'm just going to go out there and keep the same intensity and the same desire to win a national championship.
Well, Seikaly is within two of that career high here tonight against Schintzius, and we have 12:15 to go in regulation.
I think a psychologist could make something out of those statements.
Trish, and it is 54-49. Now, Florida hit seven of its first nine shots in the second half, but they have missed their last seven.
54-49.
They need some offensive production from the big fella. He's had his shots. He just has lacked that real delicate shooting touch here so far.
Well, how about Jones getting loose on the inside side?
That's been quiet, though, by Maxwell, and the M&M boys continue to blaze away for the Gators.
Well, they've been all as advertised here in the second half.
Boy, the three-point three-point play, keeping Florida in this game against Syracuse.
You really have to be careful whoever Moten's guard when you throw him the ball, because he's so quick.
Run down by Jones. Florida in a tying position here. Schintzius looking past. Pat Lawrence, three-point, and Florida takes the lead. 55-54. They have hit 7 three-point shots.
You know what I like about Norm Sloan's coach into this game? Although he uses a lot of people, he now seems to find out who tonight is going to get in the game.
Trash. Spinning reverse layup. Syracuse regains the lead. Not always important who starts a basketball game, it's who finishes it.
And I'm referring to the guy whose man got away from there, Pat Lawrence, but he's given him a solid play tonight.
Into Schintzius, turned around to the left hand and showed us up. Just forget the right hand.
That's right. That was the trouble, friend. He got shooting for the right.
All left hand for the rest of the way.
You're right. That, did the half hook look a little better with the left hand?
It did.
I didn't know he had the left hand half hook.
Monroe, he bangs in a two-point field goal. His fourth field goal of the second half. And Syracuse up by a point. We go down, changing the lead. 10-minute mark. We had six lead changes here. Maxwell getting inside.
Oh, what a great shot.
Seven lead changes, 19 for the game for Vernon Maxwell.
Now, there's a case where Maxwell scored on Trish, but what really caused that is Seikaly didn't come out on the solid screen to help Trish out a little bit.
Coleman in low.
Moten's not going for that overhead ball pick.
Seikaly and Schintzius in his face. His fourth personal foul. Dwayne Schintzius picks up his fourth personal foul with 9:38 to go in the New Jersey Meadowlands. Along with Billy Packer, I'm Brent Musburger. Florida battles back to take a one-point lead, 59-58, but their 7-2 center, Dwayne Schintzius, in foul trouble, and he will take a break right now. Kenny McClary replaces Schintzius. Ronnie Montgomery and Clifford Lett also checks into the game.
Shooting two.
Here's Seikaly's opportunity to tie his career high, right? Schintzius with his head down on the screen. Has really been burned by Ronnie Seikaly tonight. Maybe the experience factor has been the difference.
Ties his career high, gives Syracuse the lead. 37 in regulation. 14 fouls on Florida, 3 on Syracuse. Remember, you go to 1-1 on 17 fouls in a college game. Maxwell's 3 not there, but underneath, Clifford Lett rebounding and drawing the foul on Coleman, his second.
McClary running his mouth again in there. I tell you,
Syracuse foul.
Tough to have a man like that that's on your case.
Larry, the junior, Coleman, the freshman, and Clifford Lett, the sophomore from Pensacola, at the free throw line. He can give the Gators the lead.
Ron Sloan really showing a lot of confidence in this bench. Even though they were down, he's still rotating people in there, and they're starting to become more positive when they come off the bench.
Seikaly. Montgomery gave him a step and he took it. Montgomery not as quick as Moten, who is out of the game right now. 8 points for Douglas.
62-60.
You see Moten right behind the ball handler there with both shoes. He's got his shoe off.
Jones. McClary's rebound. His ankle, his right ankle, retaped. That's why he's out. As the Gators tie this game again at 62-37. Short.
Nice defense by Jones. Even though he's given up about 3-4 inches, he really stayed with it.
That's three. And the Gators behind the three-point play. Syracuse's ball, speaking of the bench, Jim Boeheim's bench, again, has not contributed a single point from Brower or Thompson tonight. Norm Sloan's bench has scored 21 points as a result of that three by Lett.
Brent, you know what's starting to be a factor? And just noticing the Syracuse players, they're bending over, grabbing those pants. And you know what that always means? A little sign of fatigue, and this is what Florida counts on with that bench.
So perhaps Boeheim wrong. The depth didn't mean a thing in the NCAA because it's starting to show up here. Stolen.
The quickness factor really moving over in Florida's behalf.
Florida quicker than Purdue, and now they're starting to show that quickness here against Syracuse. 65-62, the Gators.
Syracuse is getting tired. They may have to go back to the zone defense because they can't handle a man-to-man.
Timeout has been called by Boeheim and Syracuse. They are down by five. 7:39 left in regulation. Florida with its biggest lead of the game. Three timeouts left for Sloan, two for Boeheim. Both teams at the four-team foul mark. Important stat, the Gators ahead by the 5 points. And Billy Packer, you said it at halftime that the guards have to change this game for Florida, and they did.
They really have changed the game around. You've got 20 points in the second half out of the M&M boys, so the game has become a game of guard play. Syracuse has got to get it back to a game of inside power. That was a much-needed timeout for Syracuse. They're starting to show some real fatigue.
Monroe coming in, and there was a push by Lett. That's the second personal foul.
His second is the fifth team foul.
7:30 to go in regulation.
Jimmy Boeheim went to an Eastern Finals in 57. Went up against a team from North Carolina.
Chris comes around the screen beautifully to the inside.
Seniors don't like to play that last game, Brent.
Leading it by three. McClary and Jones operating down in the hole for the Gators here. And Pat Lawrence misfiring. Seikaly coming out with a rebound. Florida has out-rebounded Syracuse. Seikaly muscling that. It's the first personal foul on Moten.
Norm Sloan signaling he wants a jump ball. Jimmy Boeheim wants a foul, but no way it could have been a jump ball.
He also wants Seikaly to get that ball up in the air when he yanks that rebound out. So he can make that pass. Big fella start bringing that ball down low and somebody with a hands like Moten. I mean, Moten will pick you clean down there with hands like that.
Rose been bringing the ball up against the press so Douglas can be free down inside offensively. Nice job by Maxwell. Just
they
takes
don't
away to
leave Maxwell out of the game very long, do they? They send him right back in.
Florida doing a great job. Three-point defense.
Three by Monroe. Coleman's offensive rebound. Fresh 45 for Syracuse. Stolen and knocked back into the hands of Coleman. Traveling. It goes over to Florida.
You know, Jimmy Boeheim, and you review this particular game, and next year with Coleman coming back, you say, what in the world were you thinking about being that far away from the basket trying to make a play? Give it back up, get back inside where you can be effective. Sometimes it's not good to have a big freshman that can handle the ball fairly well. He wants to play guard.
Trish came over, influenced the shot. Coleman, defensive rebound, looks out, let to Douglas. Hits Seikaly off his hands, out of bounds. Boeheim wanting a foul and that collision underneath.
Gripe on that one. Syracuse stays man to man. Florida really quick out there with four players that have a decided quickness advantage.
There was the quickness getting Maxwell free and he hits the two. 69 to 64 and 21 by Norman Maxwell.
Trish cannot stay with Maxwell when there's any type of screen at all. The man that's being screened's got to help him and come out there and double team.
Down away, that is the team's seventh foul going against Moten, his second. The Gators reach the 1-1 as they go over it with 17 fouls. Syracuse still with a pair to give. Timeout has been called by Norm Sloan. That'll leave him with two and Boeheim with two. So we'll be right back for the final 5:39. Well, for Florida, the 7-2 freshman center, Dwayne Schintzius, returns. He'll play with four personals. He has pulled down six of his 11 rebounds this half.
Brent, I think
only 6 points. Now, the other story I want to cover right now is number five, Andrew Moten. Florida fans are aware that he suffered a dislocated left shoulder on December 19th. The word from the bench is when he was out, because he had been hit up there, the shoulder sometimes goes numb. And that's why he was out the last time. There is nothing wrong with the ankle. He just took the opportunity to change some equipment over there. Now the missed free throw. Rebound is pulled away by McCleary, and here come the Gators.
You know, that injury to Moten broke 100 consecutive starts that he had going a string at Florida. And the point I was making about Norm Sloan putting Schintzius back in, with 5:22 to go, you know you don't want him in there at the very end of the game. So if he's going to pick up his fifth, you might as well go with him now. No sense protecting him anymore. Nice reverse.
Great block by Coleman. Outlet to Douglas. 3-on-1. Douglas to Trish. Chance for the three-point play.
Could be a five-point turnaround, Brent. Moten had it all. Great reverse dribble by Moten. Excellent block inside. Good outlet pass. That's the first time Syracuse has really looked ahead and hit. Trish fills the lane. Maxwell with the foul. Opportunity for three.
Bill Russell's favorite kind of block shot. You keep it in play and you don't ram the ball out of bounds. Gators come down, up by two. 69-67. We hit inside the 5-minute mark.
Now here comes the solid screen. Maxwell doesn't go for it that time. He's waiting for his chances. Here comes a solid screen.
Maxwell, the hammering underneath, and it'll go against Florida. That is the fourth personal on McCleary. So from the Meadowlands, along with Billy Packer, I'm Brent Musburger. Syracuse built an early lead, but they've been turning the ball over 15 times for the game. The Gators hit 8 three-pointers. Maxwell comes alive in the second half, 21 for the game. Seikaly of Syracuse ties his career high, and the freshman Coleman moves to the free throw line with a chance to tie it. Remember, shooting 1-1, and it becomes critical in this game. Syracuse still with a couple of team fouls to give. Off the bench, number three, Pat Lawrence returns for Florida.
Seikaly at 23 at halftime, Brent. So you can see that Syracuse really hasn't pumped it into him like they did the first half.
Schintzius. Over through everything. Out of bounds it goes.
Schintzius has missed that jump hook. Matter of fact, most of them have been air balls tonight with the right hand. The only one he's hit has been the one that he shot with his left hand. Maybe expecting a little more body against him, you know, not feeling that pressure's gone high.
But remember, he's only 18 years old. A lot of time for improvement. He'll get smoother with that shot.
Nobody on Douglas.
Whips it to Trish. What a pretty pass. Maxwell breaks into the clear. That's why the football coaches like him.
Defensive back and wide receiver. They take your pick, huh?
Well, if he doesn't make it in the NBA, some team in the NFL write down his name. He's only a junior.
He'll be making it in the NBA.
Inside the Seikaly. He came up on Schintzius. Through the personal foul.
Syracuse asking for the basket, but the basket definitely didn't count here.
Seikaly only fouled him twice to get open.
That's right, push off.
Rony Seikaly gets away with two pushes and draws the fifth personal on the freshman, who fouls out with 11 rebounds and 6 points. And Melvin Jones, the 6'5 senior, number 34, into the lineup. For Florida fans, on the floor, Jones, Pat Lawrence, Moten, Maxwell, and number 21, Kenny McCleary. One of the things about McCleary, Billy, to keep in mind is he's a horrible free throw shooter, apparently. He can hurt you sometimes down the stretch of games. We'll see how that unfolds. Seikaly puts Syracuse up by two at the 3:37 mark.
Seikaly and Coleman hitting the two apiece from the free throw line.
So
we've got the quick small team on the floor now. Good job by Syracuse coming out and pressing. They all of a sudden look like they've caught their second wind here.
Jones and Coleman was there. The size advantage. But Pat Lawrence underneath can't get it to go down. Maxwell has it wind up in his hands. Moten's great quickness. Dish inside. Hit by Syracuse. Florida's ball for Norm Sloan.
That was a good pass, and Jones really should have been there.
Underneath, Maxwell muscles in the field goal to tie it. 2:57.
Syracuse now starting to spread out their offense a little bit. He's thinking lob.
33 for Rony Seikaly.
McCleary just too small if he gets him on his hip.
Vernon Maxwell has scored 20 points here in the second half. Inside to Jones. Douglas comes over on him. Draws the personal foul. His third of the game. Syracuse with a couple to give.
Syracuse foul.
They still have one more to give. That's five team fouls at the 2:23 mark.
Brent, with the decided quickness advantage for Florida, if they get the ball inside and cut off, they're going to be open.
Very short.
Pat Lawrence again.
And reaching in was Trish, his second.
Pat Lawrence has really done the job off the boards tonight. He got a piece of that last one, kept the ball alive. Interesting thing about Norm Sloan, he's been the only coach that I know of has been the coach of the year in three different conferences, the Southern, the ACC, and the Southeastern. Quite a move.
Well, now Syracuse has given the two fouls. Maxwell comes up, Seikaly helped out, influenced the shot. Moten puts it in, and Syracuse doing a bad job of clearing out. Angry words exchanged again.
Slightly having 33 points tonight, taking care of being the mediator. There's Norm Sloan looking in. You know what's available right now, Brent? Syracuse can get an easy breakaway because Florida's sending five men to the boards.
Seikaly helps out against the pressure. And the Gators retreat. 75. We're at 150. Coleman. Long pass. Maxwell goes down. It goes over.
Yeah. Although Maxwell is great at receiving those long passes, with the score as tight as it is, you don't want to take a chance unless it's right there. Here's Coleman going in on the replay. Makes a good stuff. Maxwell breaks, and there's not a wise choice of a pass.
With Dwayne Schintzius out, Melvin Jones goes 6'5", McCleary goes 6'7", Seikaly, though, goes 6'10", and Derrick Coleman goes 6'9". A size advantage down in the paint area for Syracuse. They lead by two, coming down toward 1:30.
This is the first game this year of a Big Ten, a Big East team going against the SEC team. First time they faced each other.
As the gamble fails. It's a four-point lead. Moten couldn't come up with the steal. It's 79-75. Florida has used that three-point shot here tonight. They go inside to McCleary, who misses, and it's Syracuse's game to lose. Monroe will come up and shoot 1-1. Lawrence commits the personal foul inside of a minute, and Syracuse is ahead of Coach Sloan, and Florida 79-75.
Good power move inside. rebound. Monroe doing a good job. As I said, seniors don't like to play that last game. Norm Sloan trying to get timeout.
He gets it.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Well, Billy, the strategy now is around the three-point play. As far as the Gators are concerned, they have hit 8 of 18 here in this game. And Sloan will have to use the three-pointer to climb back in this. 79-75. Syracuse with the lead. 59 seconds to go. And Rony Seikaly turns in his career game here tonight. 33 points for Coach Jim Boeheim.
Seikaly and Coleman, if at all possible. He's got to foul and use the three-point play, down 4. Nobody on the floor in foul trouble for his team, so they can use their quickness to go ahead after. Monroe, and this is really interesting, when you watch a guy play, he's been a good scorer all year long, averaging over almost 13 points a game, has only been to the foul line 50 times on the year. Does that tell you a little bit about where he likes to play on the perimeter?
They build a 6-point lead for Boeheim.
Look for the screens for Maxwell and Moten now to get the three pointers off quickly.
Short, out of bounds, Gators ball. Seikaly touched it.
Fred, that was a set play to get Lawrence the ball over there, but I really think they've got to get the ball to Maxwell because he can go ahead and create the three-point offense off the dribble, whereas Lawrence has got to be a standstill shooter. No value to shoot a 2.
Over and back. Moten saves it with a great athletic move, and Lawrence pumps one from the outside. 71-78 with 30 seconds. Long pass to Douglas, who draws the foul on Moten. Sherman Douglas breaks free at the receiving end. I can't get over how Moten managed to save that over and back, staying in the air and rifling it back. And they hit the field goal that keeps them in this with 30 seconds to go. A remarkable play.
Let's see how far he actually.
Unbelievable save by Moten. He didn't step on the line.
Might have been, Brent, but he was already back there. So it wasn't a good play.
Free throws from Syracuse here tonight.
If we see that play again, you'll see his foot was over the line. But all for naught because it counted.
Maxwell on the move. Yanked away by Coleman. Jones comes after him. Night for Coleman inside. Knowing how critical that miss is inside. 18 seconds. And Syracuse headed for the East Regional Final.
Down 5. That wasn't a bad move for Maxwell to go and get 2 because 2 at that point is just as good as 3, but you got to come down and get the 3 a time later. If the 2 was available, it's a good move to take. As a young man, I'll think about this game for a while.
Oh, oh, oh. gives it back out and throws up another three.
He hits this one, 85 to 81.
6 seconds. Syracuse up by four, and they will have possession. Florida needs a steal and then a quick three-pointer. 6 seconds to work with.
Well, they've got to go for the steal on the inbounds pass, but then immediately foul. They can't afford to allow any seconds to tick off the clock.
And they break Trish. Syracuse wins it and will go to the East Region Final.